They called him God, one of the greatest of all time, but it came at a cost.
Most footballers know what it's like to cop a heavy knock.
One he says he's continuing to pay, with scans revealing the 61-year-old has brain damage.
He suffers from memory loss, depression, anxiety, and very much it's an isolating condition in the face of being such a high-profile individual.
And he's launching legal action against the AFL and his two former clubs, Hawthorn and Geelong, claiming they breached their duty of care.
Football back in the 70s, 80s and even into the 90s, of course, the concussion wasn't taken very seriously. It was not considered to be a permanent condition, and so players were expected, when they got concussed, just to go back on the field as soon as possible once they passed the most basic test.
They have obviously cleaned the game up a lot more these days.
It comes on the heels of two class actions launched last month, claiming permanent damage from head knocks.
It's terrifying for so many of these players to think, what is their future going to look like?
But the difficulty for the old guard is linking historical impact to current injury.
He fixed Ablett right up, went for the man.
With their actions off field also likely to be under scrutiny.
When you talk about a breach of duty of care or negligence, you have to show that you were doing something wrong when you knew that you're doing it wrong. And this is where I think it's such a difficult argument.
But as more players line up for compensation, insiders say the very future of the game is at risk.
We now have this difficulty of knowing the sport's reputation is under risk, and they're facing an incredible dilemma, because parents are going to look at sports and say, well, I don't want Jimmy or Jill to play that sport because they might get a head injury.
Shaun Smith's a former Melbourne player who's heading up a class action of potentially hundreds of former players against the AFL. He's been good enough to join us. Shaun, how significant is it that Gary Ablett Sr. has joined the long list of footballers suing the code?
Oh, that's huge, because Gary's one of the greats of all time. I'm not sure if he kicked 1,000 goals, but he kicked very close to that. You know, if the AFL can't look after one of the greats, and he put a lot of bums on seats every week, and they used to walk end-to-end to watch him play. It's a shame that it has to go to that to get some help.
His particular case is complicated, though, isn't it? Because, I mean, he was in his pomp through the 80s and the early 90s. What was it reasonable to expect that the AFL and the clubs would have known about concussion and how to treat it back then? Not now, but back then.
Well, I know that they did studies back in the 80s on concussion, and they've known about concussion. You don't have to be a scientist to work out if you get belted around the head a lot, you're going to get some sort of damage to your brain. Of course, the player always wants to go back on the ground, always wants to play, but it's got to be taken out of the player's hands and done with some science.
That's actually, you kind of raised there one of the arguments that the AFL, I think, is going to make. They've sort of hinted at this, which is, this is a case of what they call voluntary assumption of risk. When you play this game, you know you're going to get head knocks, you know there'll be consequences of that. You assume that risk, you take that on. What are your thoughts on that approach?
Well, that's a really good question. I didn't sign up to get hurt. You know, you jump in your car, you know, you could be seriously hurt in your car, you know the risks. You know, firemen, policemen, every day they're putting themselves at risk. They know the risks. But if they get hurt, they get a thing called work cover. You know, I can't believe an AFL the size of the company they are, or the business they are, that they don't have a work cover scheme.
Of course, with all of this news coming out about concussion, it doesn't sound good, right, for parents especially who are trying to get their kids into sport. AFL's looking like a bad idea, but I understand that your two kids play AFL. Did you have some concerns about that, playing Aussie rules?
Well, you know, they're grown adults. They make their own decisions. Joel, they were both playing basketball to, up until, you know, Joel was 18, and then he just switched to footy. And then just out of the blue, at the age of 18, Amy decided to play footy again, which sort of made her mother really happy. they know that if they get a whack, that I'll be stepping in and they will be looked after. But what we're trying to do is make the game safer. So, you know, adults will go, well, if so-and-so is going to get a concussion, I mean, you can get concussions playing basketball and, you know, lower contact sports. If you fall over and hit your head on the court always wins, you know. So it's how you treat it. And that's the one thing we're trying to push is, yes, Yes, there are dangers, but if you do get hurt, you're going to be looked after.
Shaun, thank you for your time.
No worries. Thank you.